Welcome student, today we are going to study of the angle bisector of a given angle. So how do we find that? It's a practical geometry. Angle bisector of an angle. How do you find that one? What is the meaning of angle bisector of an angle? Angle bisector of an angle, if a line or line segment divides an angle into two equal angles, then the line or line segment is called angle bisector of the given angle. Angle bisector of an angle, if a line or line segment divides an angle into two equal angles. For example, 60 degree mean we are going to divide it into two equal angles, 30 and 30. Then the lines or line segment is called the angle bisector of the given angle. Be some 100 degree. 100 degree mean what kind of angle? More than 90 degree, that is called the obtuse angle. The same procedure only you have to follow. Draw a line segment AB is equal to 6 cm. Next, we are going to take the protractor. How to keep your protractor? So first, we have to draw the line segment AB equal to 6 cm. In your convenient only, any radius you are going to draw. 6 cm, 7, 8, etc. Anyone. Okay. Next, how to keep a protractor C, that is keep it on the line segment AB. Okay, wow, that is zero level is on the line segment. Therefore, how to draw mark that one? This is the first one 0 degree, next line 10 degree, next 20. Below only you have to see. Don't see up, again and again see from right to left. We are going to see in the protractor below only 0, first one the on the line 0 degree is there. Next 10, next 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. 100 you have to mark that one. Okay, mark the pencil. Then join AC. Next, join AC. Take your scale and join AC. Now what you do? With the same, with A as center, and you are going to take the convenient radius, draw an arc to cut AB at D and to and AC. Mark the point of intersection AE on AC, D on AB. Can you understand all of you? With A as center, take the compass. I told the first previous exercise compass level, compass how to pencil level and compass tip, both are in equal level. We are going to see that one. So with A as center, with A as center and convenient radius. Convenient radius, now you are going to take any radius in your choice only. In your eyesight, any radius you are going to take. Draw an arc to cut AB at D and AC at E. Again, you have to say with A as center and you are going to take the convenient radius. Draw an arc to cut AB at D and AC at E. Next step, don't change your radius. Okay, don't change your radius with the same radius. Don't change your radius with the same radius and D as center. Draw an arc in the interior of an angle ABC. Can you understand? Don't change your angle, sorry, don't change your radius with the same radius and D as center. Draw an arc in the interior of the angle BAC. சி சென்டர் தான் ஆங்கிள். கேன் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? ஆர் சிஏபி எனி ஒன் யூ ஹாவ் டு சே பிஏசி ஆர் சிஏபி. அகெய்ன் யூ ஹாவ் டு சே தட் வித் ஏ அ சென்டர் அண்ட் ஃபார் யுவர் கன்வீனியன்ட் ரேடியஸ் ட்ரா என் ஆர் டு கட் ஏபி அட்டு டி அண்டு ஏசி அட்டு இ. கேன் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ? எஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி தட் ஒன். ஏபி ஏபி அட்டு டி ஏசி அட்டு இ. நவ் வித் டி அஸ் சென்டர் த சேம் ரேடியஸ் ஒன்லி டோன்ட் சேஞ்ச் யுவர் ரேடியஸ் வித் டி அஸ் சென்டர் ட்ராயன் ஆர்க் ட்ராயன் ஆர் இன் தி இன்டீரியர் ஆஃப் த ஆங்கிள் ஏபி. நெக்ஸ்ட்டு வித் இ அஸ் சென்டர் வித் இ அஸ் சென்டர் அண்ட் ட்ராயன் அனதர் ஆர் டு கட் த ப்ரிவியஸ் ஆர் கட்டு எஃப் டு கட் த ப்ரிவியஸ் ஆர் கட்டு எஃப். Can you understand all of you? First one, with the same radius, don't change your radius with D as center. With D as center, draw an arc in the interior, interior of angle BAC or CAB. Next, with CE as center, don't change your radius with C, it's the same radius. With E as center, draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at F. Now, we are going to join AF. Take a scale and join AF. AF is the required bisector of the angle BAC or CAB. Can you understand? AF, take the scale and join AF. Join AF is the required bisector of the given angle BAC or CAB. Can you understand? First one, we are going to draw the angle BAC or CAB with a measure of 100 degree using the protractor. Can you understand? First you have to construct the angle 100 degree using the protractor. Next, with A as center and take any convenient radius, draw an arc to cut the arc AB at D and AC at E. Next, with the same radius and D as center, draw an arc in the interior of angle ABC. And the same radius ES center, draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at F. Now we are going to join AF. AF is the required bisector of the given angle BAC or CAB. Can you understand? Now BAC equal to 50 degree. BAF equal to 50 degree and CAF equal to 50 degree or FAB equal to 50 degree, FAC equal to 50 degree. Okay, divided into equal. Next, now we are going to see the construction. Already I told construction we are writing the pencil only in the left side of the practical geometry notebook. You have to see that one. Next one. Construction. Draw the given angle using protractor. Draw the given angle using protractor. Next step, with A as center, draw an arc to cut AB and AC. Mark the point of intersection as D on AB and E on AC. Next step 3, with the same radius and D as center, draw an arc in the interior and draw another arc of same radius with E as center to cut the previous arc. Next one, mark the point of intersection of F. Join A and F to get the required angle bisector of the given angle. Can you understand all of you? Now we are going to see the next sum. 90 degree. 90 degree mean what kind of angle? Exactly, angle is exactly equal to 90 degree is called the right angle. Can you understand? The same procedure only with take a ruler and draw a line segment AB equal to 6 centimeter. Can you understand? Next, we are going to see with A as center, and then what you do using the protractor, you have to construct the angle 90 degree. How to keep that is a protractor on the line. Keep a line on the line AB. It's a zero level. How to keep it on this? See the videos carefully. Okay, how to keep it on that one? Then you have to see from right to left only. See the below only you have to see. Below only you have to see. See 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. That is straight line only. Okay, wow. Now mark 90 degree. Now we are going to join AC. Now CAB is equal to 90 degree. Now we are going to find the angle bisector. How do you find that angle bisector? With A as center, it's a 90 degree. Can you understand all of you? Next, the same procedure only. How to take that one? With A as center. With A as center, take that already I told the. So compass tip and pencil tip both are equal level only. With A as center, and we are going to take the convenient radius. Convenient, your choice only, any radius you are going to take. Okay, wow. Then your eyesight only. Not only you are going to take the ruler, only your eyesight only. With B, A as center and convenient radius, draw an arc. Or to A, draw an arc A to cut AB at D, AB at D, AC at E. Okay, with A as center and convenient radius, draw an arc to cut AB at D, AC at E. That is with the same radius only, with the same radius and D as center. Next step. With the same radius and D as center, draw an arc in the interior of the angle CAB or BAC. Okay, any you have to say that is with D as center. Say again, you have to say with the same radius, don't change it. D as center, draw an arc in the interior of the angle ABC. Next, the same radius, don't change your angle, change your radius with E as center and draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at F. Therefore, mark the point of intersection as F. F is now we are going to take the ruler and again I have to say. With PS D as center and convenient radius, draw an arc to cut AB at D and AC at E. Next, don't change your radius, the same radius, with the same radius D as center, draw an arc in the interior of the angle BAC or CAB. Next, E as center and the same radius, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at F. Again, we have to say first step with A as center and convenient radius, draw an arc to AB at D, AC at E. With the same radius and D as center, draw an arc in the interior of the angle ABC. Next, E as center, draw another arc to cut the previous arc at F. Now, take the ruler and join AF. Now, AF is the required bisector of the given angle CAB or BAC. Now, we are going to measure that angle FAB FAC is equal to 45 degree. Can you understand both the angles are equal? Now, we are going to see that what construction. You have to now you have to take this measure, that is FAB or CAF, both are 45 degree. Can you see that one? Yes. Okay, next we are going to move that one. Construction: draw the given angle using protractor. Second step, with A as center, draw an arc to cut AB and AC. Mark the point of intersection at D on AB and E on AC. Next, with the same radius and D as center, draw an arc in the interior and draw another arc of same radius with E as center to cut the previous arc. Now, mark the point of intersection as F. Join A and F to cut the required angle bisector of the given angle. Already I told D and E is a homework. Do the homework and take the photocopies to the concerned your math teacher. Do you have any doubt, means you have to ask your math teachers. Okay. Construction of angles without using protractor. Now move on the exercise 5.5. Construct the angle using ruler and compass only. 60 degree, 120 degree, 30 degree, 90 degree, 45 degree, 150 degree, 135 degree. So 150 and 135 degree is the homework for the other 5. You have to do that one. First one, 60 degree. First, draw a line or line segment. Draw a line segment. Next, you have to use any convenient radius. Mark A on it. With A as center, draw an arc to cut the line at B. At P, with the same radius, don't change the radius, with the same radius, with B as center, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at C. Join AC. Now, angle BAC is a required angle. Angle BAC equal to 60 degree. Now again I told it, draw a line, mark a point A on it. Draw a line, mark a point A on it. With A as center, we are going to take any convenient radius. Draw an arc to cut the arc at the line B, at B. Next, with the same radius, with B as center, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at C. Join AC. Now, angle BAC equal to 60 degree. Now, we are going to see the construction. Draw a line, mark a point A on it. With A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line to meet at a point B. With the same radius and B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. Join AC. Then angle BAC is the required angle with a measure 60 degree. Second one, 120 degree. First draw a line and mark a point A on it. With A as a center, you are going to take any convenient radius, draw an arc to cut the arc at the line at B. See, any radius with a convenient radius. With B as center, the same radius with B as center and draw an arc to cut the previous arc with B as center to draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. With same radius with C as center and draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at D. Now join AD. Now angle BAD is the required angle when I join AD. Now angle BAD is the required angle 120 degree. Again we have to see, first draw a line, mark a point A and it. With A as center, with any convenient radius, draw an arc to cut the line at B. Next, with B as center, the same radius, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. Then don't change the radius, with the same radius, with C as center, and draw the arc to cut the previous arc at T. Join AD. Now angle BAD is the required angle 120 degree. Now we are going to see the construction. Draw a line, mark a point A on it. With A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line to meet at a point B. With the same radius and B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. With the same radius and C as center, draw an arc to cut the arc at the previous arc at D. Join AD. Then angle BAD is the required angle with the measure 120 degree. Next one, third question, 30 degree. 30 degree means half of the degree, 60 degree. Now we are going to construct angle 60 degree. Next we are going to bisecting the angle 60 degree, 30. We can construct 30 degree by bisecting the angle of 60 degree. The same procedure by first we are going to constructing the angle 60 degree. Draw a line, mark a point A on it. With A as center, draw an arc to cut at the line B. The same radius with B as center, draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at C. Join AC. Join AC. Now the angle of interior BAC with the same radius B as a center to cut the previous arc at C. Now join AC. Now angle BAC equal to 60 degree. With the same radius B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. Join AC to get angle BAC equal to 60 degree. Now we are going to see the with B as center, draw an arc of convenient radius in the interior angle of BAC. Again we have to say, with B as center, With B as center, draw an arc of convenient radius in the interior of angle BAC. With the same radius, C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. With the same radius and C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. Join AD. Now angle BAD is the required angle of measure 30 degrees. Now we are going to see the construction. Construct angle 60 degrees. With B as center, draw an arc of convenient radius in the interior of angle BAC. With the same radius and C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. Join AD, then angle BAD is the required angle with measure 30 degrees. Next, 90 degrees. First, draw a line and mark a point A on it. With A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line at a point P. With A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line at a point B. With the same radius, B as a center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. With the same radius and B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. With the same radius and C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. Join AD. Next, angle BAD equal to 120 degrees. With the convenient radius of the arc of interior in the CD, with the C as center, draw an arc. With the same radius, D as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at E. Now join AE. Now angle EAB is equal to 90 degrees. First one, draw a line and a mark a point A on it. Next, with A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line at a point B. Next point, with the same radius and B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. Next, with the same radius and C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. Next, the angle interior of BAD, CD, that is the radius of BD. We are taking the convenient radius. Draw an arc to at C as a center. Draw an arc. Next, the same radius with D as a center. Draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at E. Now join AE. Now angle EAB is equal to 90 degrees. Construct angle 120 degrees. With C as center, draw an arc of convenient radius in the interior of angle CAD. With the same radius and D as center, draw an arc to cut the arc. Draw a second step at E. Join AE, then angle BAE equal to 90 degrees is the required angle. Then fifth one, 45 degree. 45 degree mean the same procedure for 90 degree. First draw a line and mark the point A on it. Next, with A as center, draw an arc of convenient radius to the line at a point B. With B as center, draw the same radius. With B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. Next, with C as center, the same radius, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at D. Now, the interior angle of CAD, the interior angle of CAD, we are going to convenient radius of C, interior angle of CAD, with C as center, draw an arc. Next, D, with the same radius, with D as center, draw an arc to cut the arc at the previous arc at E, join AE. Now, the angle FAB, interior angle FAB, that is a with B as center, interior angle of BAF with a convenient radius, with B as center, draw an arc, with F as center, draw an another arc to cut the previous arc at G. Now join AG. Angle GAB is equal to 45 degree. Again, we have to say, draw a line, mark a point A on it. With A as center, draw an arc to cut the previous cutter line at B. With the same radius, with B as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at C. With the same radius, with C as center, draw an arc to cut the previous arc at D. Now, interior angle CAD, that is with a convenient radius, you have to take the CD of the convenient radius. With C as center, draw an one arc. With the same radius, with D as center, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at E. Now join AE. Next, that AE at F, we have to cut one the angle of CAF, the interior angle of BAF. With B as center, we are going to convenient interior angle BAF or FAB. We are going to take any convenient radius. With B as center, draw an arc, and F as center, draw in another arc to cut the previous arc at G. Join AG. Now, angle GAB or BAG is equal to 45 degree. Now we are going to see that construct angle 90 degree. With B as center, draw an arc of convenient radius in the interior of angle BAE. Next, with the same radius and F as center, draw an arc to cut the arc drawing the step 2 at G. Now join AG. Then angle BAG equal to 45 degree is the required angle. Now that is 150 and 135 is the homework for you. 150 can be 120 degree plus 30 degree. 150 can be written as 120 plus 30 degree. 135 degree can be written as 90 degree plus 45 degree. Can you understand that two sums are homework for you? Thank you, children.